You talk too much, you even worry my pet. You just talk too much.
Welcome to Let's Talk. I'm your host, Ariana Perez, and in today's episode, we'll be talking about the Marvel Cinematic Universe, in which is in its phase 5, currently filled with awesome movies and series. But today we'll be focusing on our favorite movies. Today I have here with me Justin Hidalgo. How are you, Justin?
I'm good, thank you for inviting me to the show.
What do you think of Marvel? How come you like it so much?
Honestly, Marvel's just been like that thing for me. It's just like my dad introduced it to me when I was like at a young age. I like collect the action figures and everything. I still do, like the Marvel Legends figures and stuff. And like I watched the movies, I read the comics and everything, and
since
I was just
childhood.
Yeah, it was just something I was just always into since like a kid.
Yeah, and also here with me I have Caden Nagel. Hi, Caden. How are you?
I'm good.
How come you like Marvel so much? When did you start liking it?
I grew up, you know, playing like Lego Marvel at my friend's house and stuff like that, and I always watched the movies, like the cartoons too, and it's just such a great way of telling stories through all these unique characters who come from all these different, you know, sections of the universe.
And it's yeah, I completely agree. And today we talked about deciding on one film that we think it's like the best for us or we liked a lot. We'll be discussing it today. So first off, for the first movie, I've decided to pick the first Avengers film, which came out in 2012. So let's take a look at a clip of it.
So, this all seems horrible.
I've seen worse.
Sorry.
No, we could use a little worse.
Stark, we got him.
Banner?
Just like you said.
Then tell him to suit up. I'm bringing the party to you.
I don't see how that's a party.
Banner, now might be a really good time for you to get angry.
That's my secret, Captain. I'm always angry.
So this was such an iconic movie on so many levels. Of course, it was like the first moment that the whole movies prior to this one build up to like this such a big event, because like all of the characters we've known from the other movies just came together and like acted on it. So what did you think of it when it came out?
Honestly, the Avengers, I remember when I was watching in the theater, I was like maybe 6 or 7. Mm-hmm. And I remember my dad brought me to it. Like I remember before I watched like Iron Man, I watched like Hulk, I watched Captain America and Thor, I watched like all the other movies in the theater. So as soon as I like started with Marvel, I was just into it. So when I remember when I saw like the first Avengers in the theater, I was just like mind blown as a kid, because like I was like it was just like something that was there that I was just like, wow, that's amazing.
Yeah,
like,
just the action, the interactions with everyone.
Yeah,
it
and
was
like
awesome.
The amount of characters and like the amount of action they had like fluently throughout the entire film. Like it was really like, especially like that one scene where they're like all standing in the middle fighting.
Yeah.
Everything, that was like so iconic.
Yeah, I completely agree. It was like so genuine. Did you think it was genuine?
Yeah, obviously the casting people did an amazing job. No, Robert Downey Jr. just is Iron Man. Like it fits him so well. Everyone fits their roles so well. And their chemistry together is amazing. You can actually believe that, you know, these people have been like friends and working together and fighting these villains side by side for years, and they really, you know, interact really well together.
Did you see it in theaters too?
I did not see it in theaters. I didn't really watch the movies until I was like probably 10, so we watched all of them on streaming and stuff.
No, yeah, I get that. Like, I remember I watched it. I was like 6 years old when I watched it, but I wasn't like that into Marvel like Justin. Justin's a fanatic on another level. I just watched it, and it was like the first superhero movie I watched, and it was just like awesome. Like, even the CGI, I know it wasn't that long ago, but it was really good. It looks really good, even now compared to some effects that we see now. And I think it was just like a great movie all along, the plot, the villain, and everything.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. Honestly, me and my brother, like, after we saw this movie, every time we'd watch a movie, me and my brother would go crazy just pretending we were in the movie. And that's how my parents would know we'd like something. Because after we'd, like, get up and be, like, running around, pretend to be, like, Iron Man. I remember my brother always wanted to be Hawkeye because he thought bow and arrows were so cool and stuff. So.
Your parents are like, my kids are crazy. Huh?
Running off the walls, you know.
Jumping up the cliff.
I mean, you got to admit, when you were a kid, you were probably, like, doing the same thing.
No, yeah.
you have to have been doing the same thing. Like, I had an Iron Man costume. Yeah, I had, like, an Iron Man costume. I thought I could fly.
Yeah.
I kept banging into walls, so.
I think every little kid, if they watched it, they were, like, felt like they could do it.
Yeah, it was just, like, that one thing that every kid just fell in love with.
Yeah, and it was just, this movie, Avengers First, it was, like, such a big thing. But then later on, we came to Avengers Endgame, which is your favorite movie, right?
Yeah.
What do you think of it?
Honestly, it's my favorite movie. It's just a lot of action, and how they had like previous movies add up to like then, where they had before that Avengers Infinity War, and they led up to Endgame. And I remember I even read the comics for it before. And then like Endgame, watching that in the theater was just like, it was just crazy. There was like so many reactions from the audience. Yeah. Everybody was going crazy. There was so much action and everything. I just loved it overall.
Yeah, so like right now, let's watch a clip of Avengers Endgame.
I thought by eliminating half of life, the other half would thrive. But you've shown me that's impossible. And as long as there are those that remember what was, there will always be those that are unable to accept what can be. They will resist.
Yep, we're all kinds of stubborn.
I'm thankful. Because now, I know what I must do. I will shred this universe down to its last atom. And then, with the stones you've collected for me, create a new one, teeming with life, that knows not what it has lost, but only what it has been given. A grateful universe.
Born out of blood.
They'll never know it. Because you won't be alive to tell them.
So, like, of course, that was, like, such a big build-up to that movie, such a peak. What did you think of it when you watched it?
When I watched it, like I said before, like, the action and everything was just crazy. The amount of, CGI, like, I'm gonna be honest, like, you're watching the movie, you're not thinking about, like, oh, how they made it. You're just watching it to, like, see, like, the Avengers.
It feels real.
Yeah, and, like...
like, it's not like, oh, my God, it's not real, space aliens, whatever. No, I was like, I'm not in it. I'm not fighting it. But it was just, like, such a real experience.
Yeah, it's not like Thanos has a green screen behind him. Like, you can just see, like, it seemed real. And, like,
they're brought, in another planet.
Yeah, like, it just brought life to, like, that movie. And, like, everybody enjoyed it for, like, the amount of aspects and stuff it had. And I also like to, like, to point out how, compared to, like, other films and, like, other Avengers movies, like, they had, like, normally you think at the end of the day, the Avengers, you know, they fight whoever's bad and they win at the end of the day. And I like how in Infinity War to Endgame, it had that transition of, oh, this time they didn't win. And, like, it was
what's
more
next?
Suspenseful. Yeah, it's like, what's next? And, like, it had, like, everybody just, like, you know, like, waiting for Endgame. And then when it finally came out, everybody was just all hype about it. Like,
yeah.
It was
Did
amazing.
You like it that much, Kaden, too?
Yeah, I loved it. Obviously, you know, it didn't feel forced besides, like, maybe the women's scene. But don't hate women, but, you know. They could have done better on that.
Yeah.
And it felt like a natural closing, a natural ending to, like, a lot of storylines. And, you know, everything wrapped up real nice and nothing felt forced. And talking about the CGI, I just remember the Reality Stone scene when they're fighting, like, all the Guardians and everything. And he's, like, shifting the reality. That scene is so cool. And it looks really natural, too. It doesn't look like they're trying to force any CGI down our throats.
Yeah.
Like, you know, maybe some of the newer movies, like Quantumania or whatever, like, feels like kind of like, oh, look what we can do.
Yeah.
But
it felt like natural to the story.
Yeah, it felt right in the story. Everything closed off real nice and good. Tie a bow on top.
Did you watch it in theaters, Endgame?
I watched it in theaters 3 times. Oh. I remember the first time it was like a showing around like 5 o'clock. The second time was like a showing around like 8. And then after that, I dragged my dad to like 2 a.m. to watch it for the third time, and he fell asleep like halfway through the movie for like 10 minutes. And then I remember I was in the theater, I was like, Dad, you're falling asleep. He's like, I watched this 3 times already.
Like, I don't need to anymore.
He's like, I already watched this 3 times, I'm tired. And I was like, all right, whatever.
I remember I watched it 2 times. The first one, it was like at 1 a.m. Like, I don't know why the movie started that late. It was because there were so many like shows they had to put on because it was such high demand. And I came out of the mall like at 4 a.m. It was kind of embarrassing because everyone was cleaning up. And the second time I dragged my mom there. My mom isn't like a huge Marvel fan, but she loved Tony Stark and Iron Man. And she was like, is he okay? I was like, yeah, mom, you're good. She didn't talk to me the rest of the day, but that's fine.
No, don't worry, he just went to sleep, that's all.
The community felt like so together, like this was the, you know, like in being a Marvel, like a lot of, there's not like a lot of big, like maybe Comic-Con or whatever.
Mm. Yeah.
But when you went to go see this movie and everyone in the movie was like gasping or like, you know, laughing together. It felt like such a community event, and honestly, it felt really, really cool.
And I think this was like a period before like Disney Plus, and we have all the shows where like you don't necessarily have to go to the theater. So like I think with time, maybe like, well, after No Way Home, like everything came back to it, but like it kind of like the whole theater thing kind of like blew down a little bit, also because of COVID.
Yeah.
But I think like that moment, it was just such an epic, right before COVID, right before, it was such so good. I remember it.
Yeah, I mean, I'm gonna be honest, like, doesn't matter what it is. If it's a Marvel movie, I'm watching it in the theater first. Like,
yeah.
I'm not gonna sit at home and be like, oh yeah, there's a new Avengers movie. Yeah, I'm gonna just watch it at home. No, like I'm going to the theater. Like I'm gonna watch it there.
The big screen and everything.
Yeah, actually, before you mentioned something about Comic-Con. Yeah, I actually been to Comic-Con.
Really?
Yeah, it was actually pretty nice. They had like I went like around like the Avengers Endgame era. It was really nice.
Yeah.
Like everybody was just dressed up as someone. So.
Yeah.
And Kanan, looking at the table, I saw that you brought a little Groot here today, which is kind of, is that your favorite movie?
Yeah, I love Guardians of the Galaxy so much. My
all
favorite
three of them?
Band of Misfits.
Well, you haven't watched all three of them? Do you like all three of them?
I haven't seen the third one yet, so no spoilers. I really like the first one. I thought the second one was really good, too. I loved Star-Lord's dad and everything, that whole arc. I thought it was really good.
Yeah, so like right now, let's take a look at a clip from Guardians of the Galaxy.
Showtime, a-holes. They'll be here any minute. Go! That's my freaking father!
I think it's good, except it sucks. So let me do the plan, and that way it might be really good.
Wow. Welcome to the frickin' Guardians of the Galaxy.
So like, what did you think about that movie? I remember when it came out, it was like such a big thing. It was a big thing, like all Marvel movies, but I really liked it. What did you think of it?
Yeah, obviously, it's such a fun movie. Like, you know, maybe some of the other movies have like darker tones or whatever, a little bit more serious. This movie is just fun. You know, it's a lovable gang of misfits. They all have some issues or whatever, but they band together. And my favorite thing about them is that they're not perfect heroes, right? Mm-hmm. They do mess up, they do make bad decisions and whatnot, but they come together and obviously have a great time. Obviously, Groot and Rocket, top three duos of all time. Just so awesome.
Do you prefer Baby Groot or Adult Groot?
I don't know. I'm really excited to see preteen Groot in this next movie. It looks like it's gonna be really good. So I'm excited for that. I do prefer the original Groot.
Yeah.
Just because, I mean, fighting wise, he's just like so dominant. This big dude just shoots his arm out at you.
Yeah, that's true. And I also remember, like, I also like the music in this film. The music's so good. It's just like the whole like surrounding aspects of the movie is so well done. It's really good. What do you think of it, Justin?
The playlist in that movie was amazing, yeah.
Yeah.
I did watch the third one, no spoilers, so there's that. But I will say it was amazing. Guardians of the Galaxy though, like their entire team, I like their team because like Hayden said, they're not perfect.
Yeah.
And they do their things their way and it still works out at the end of the day, which I find like really great about them. Like, I'm gonna be honest.
Yeah, like it's different from like every other superhero.
Like, I'm gonna be honest too. At first, like, I was like, I don't know if I would like watch this, but then I got into it and I was like, okay, yeah, I'm gonna keep watching it. Like, it was just, I liked it.
Yeah, honestly. And I think it's just like a trilogy of movies that is really fun. Well, I don't know the third one, I haven't watched it, so no spoilers for me, but. It was just like, I remember it's like a lot of jokes. It's just like a light tone, but mixed with, of course, with like the whole action and the conflict. And I think it's a really well balanced movie.
They kind of remind me of like the Avengers, just with more humor.
Yeah.
That's all I can say.
Yeah. It's like Walmart Avengers.
Walmart Avengers, yeah.
But it's still good.
Yeah.
Why Walmart?
Yeah.
Why Walmart? No, but I mean, honestly, like their team overall, who'd you say is your favorite character?
Favorite from Guardians of the Galaxy?
Yeah.
Rocket, I think Rocket. He's just fun. He's just a fun character, I gotta say.
Does everybody just like Rocket?
I like Rocket.
What do you like?
I mean,
huh?
Rocket.
fighting wise, I have to say Yondu. The spear thing is so dope.
Yeah.
But personality wise, I'm going with Rocket. Too.
Yeah.
Or Drax. Drax.
Drax.
Him eating the chips and thinking he's invisible, so funny.
Yeah, it's so funny because it's like he's such a like he has all these characters like dumb traits whatever, but he's smart in the moment, and also he has his whole dark backstory like with his family is like, what?
Yeah.
So do you have any closing thoughts about Marvel in general?
As they say in Marvel, let's do that Marvel.
What do you think? Do you think it's going to like a right path, Marvel?
Honestly, I think I'm gonna be honest. Nothing's perfect, so they started off good. They continue with it, but then like they did like have some flops, and then they also had like really good comebacks, like Endgame, Guardians of the Galaxy 3. That's also a really good comeback that they're having, as like the box office has said, they're already making sales as it is, like close to Endgame, which is crazy to think about. But honestly, like Marvel is just like that thing that's known by millions of people, probably even billions, who knows?
Yeah.
But like it's known by many people overall, and it's just like it's just something that everybody like kind of knows, everybody like heard of it, and it's just been around for a really long time.
Yeah, like it or not, you've heard it.
Yeah.
It's like, do you think, Kaden, you're going to come back to it? You're going to keep watching?
Obviously. I mean, as much as like maybe I'm disappointed by some of the movies, I'm so addicted I just keep watching. And I think that says a lot about the universe that they built and the world building, that even if maybe I don't like the character or whatever, I'll still, you know, go to escape to this, you know, universe.
Yeah, like the
give it another chance always. Yeah.
Yeah, and like the community they made throughout like all the movies, just it's like a large amount of people. It's just like, I like how they have like many different characters, many different people with different backgrounds and everything all fit into like one universe.
Yeah.
And I think that's like mainly the point of Marvel.
Yeah, I completely agree. I think it's just a great community to just get an experience in. If you haven't watched any movies, Marvel movies, I recommend doing it. Just for the experience of it. But sadly, that's all we have time for tonight. Thank you for watching this episode of Let's Talk. You talk too much, you even worry my pet. You just talk.